We are going to study our one monthly lesson, the second part of the lesson, the pop and the anthem. This is written by William Sidney Porter. His pen name is O. Henry. In the first part of our lecture, we have seen that Soapy, he entered in an expensive restaurant and there he ordered Mallard Dove. Mallard Dove is a one kind of wild dove. Cheese, cup of coffee, wine and cigar. But what happened? The head waiter, he saw his torn shoes and his clothes is not up to the mark. It does not fulfill the standard of that restaurant. Okay, it was not praised. So the head waiter, he came and he told the Soapy silently to move out of the restaurant. He made him out of the restaurant. He said that you cannot afford the bill of our restaurant. So in this way, when he ordered the food, so what happened? He could not eat. They make him out. That was the story of our first passage. By second passage, what we learn? Soapy, he went nearby the shop, showroom shop. There he pelted the stone, and in this way he broken the glass window of the showroom. And he was there only, and he said that the cop should arrest him. And the policeman, they even refused to accept Soapy even as a plea, because they knew very well the person who will pelt the stone, who will commit the crime, he will not remain at the spot. So in this way, he wanted to be arrested, but he was denied by the policeman, and he wanted to be in the clutches of the policeman. But what happened? The police refused to accept that Soapy even as a Mr. Kiminar, he has committed this mistake. Okay, and they started following another man who was chasing the car. So policeman thought that this is the culprit. So they started running that man. Okay, and then what happened? Then he went to the another restaurant for eating the food. He was very hungry. So he entered in the another restaurant that was cheap. So then he ordered the food and he started eating. After eating, when the waiter comes, he says that I don't have minutest coin, I don't have even single penny. So you call the cop. Then the waiter, he says that there is no cop for you. Two waiters, they were having good scenery and muscle. They came, they hold the leg and the hand of the Soapy and they threw him out of the hotel at the footpath. So again, what happened? He's entering into the winter and the dream, he seems to be far away. Okay, whatever he is thinking, it was going just against the destiny of Soapy. So these two stories we have learned in the passage number first and second. So one after another is the whatever plan was devising, it was failing. Now in the third passage, what happened? The Soapy, he devised another plan. He entered where at the Hartford College. Hartford College come under the affiliation of the Yale University, and there he started dancing by eating by drinking the liquor. He was behaving very rudely. So what happened? The police cops, police personnel, they saw the Soapy. He was behaving very madly after drinking the liquor. So they does not arrested Soapy. Why? Because the police officer, they said that they are having the order from their higher official. So this is the annual social gathering of the college students. So today they are not going to arrest anybody. It is for entertainment purpose. They are enjoying, let them enjoy. So what happened? He was not arrested. So again his plan is becoming failed. Then now Soapy made by the crowd and he behaved madly. He entered in the show, then later on what happened? He made another plan. He did? He entered in one shop. In that shop, one man, he was having his umbrella. So that umbrella was kept beside the door. So he took that umbrella and he started claiming that this umbrella belongs to me. I am the owner of this umbrella. Then the man who was the owner of the umbrella, he himself has theft that umbrella from somewhere else. And in this way what happened? That man thought that Soapy is a real owner of this umbrella. So that man, he ran away. So in this way what happened? Again his plan is failed. So he thought that that man will call the police and this way police will arrest me and I will be behind the bar. So his dream seems to be far away. So his plan has again failed. Then next, in this way, these two plans he has devised. But again these two plans has failed. Now let us have a glance over the text. Passage number 3, page number 13. Soapy was seized with a sudden fear that some dreadful enchantment had rendered him immune to arrest. Enchantment means magic charm. Immune means enchantment, I have written here. Enchantment, magic charm. Immune means free. Her meaning is free. To arrest, he was in a static of panic, and when he came upon another policeman longing grandly in front of drifting theater. Longing means to move idly. He caught at the immediate stroke of disorderly thunder. Then what happened? He caught the immediate stroke of disorderly thunder. What is the meaning of this line? Meaning is that Soapy wanted to be arrested by the policeman and imprisoned. However, his efforts towards this end had been unsuccessful. In front of theater, an artist to him, he felt if he shout and scream and made a lot of noise, he would be arrested and disturbing way in a public and would be in prison, which was what he wanted. He thought that I will enter in the crowd, I will misbehave with the crowd. So after looking at my behavior, I would become the disturbing element of in the crowd. So police will arrest me, and in this way I will be sent to the winter island. So this was the plan. But what happened? The police person said that today there is no arrest. We will not arrest anybody. They are enjoying, let them enjoy. It is the means university program. College students there means celebrating their annual social gathering. Next. It is one of them. Yes, that celebration, the goose egg they give to the Hartford College. Noisy but no harm. We have instruction to let them be. So the police person, they say that we are having instruction. They enjoy, let them enjoy. Today means we are not going to intervene in this social gathering. Disconsolate means depressed. So Soapy was depressed when the police man cop said that today means that they are enjoying, let them enjoy. So there is no arrest. So Soapy he is depressed. He is very much annoyed. He was very much disappointed after hearing from the police personnel that they are not going to arrest him. He buttoned his thin coat against the chilling wind. In a cigar store, he saw a well-dressed man lighting a cigar at the swinging light. He had set his silk umbrella by the door on entry. Soapy stepped inside, grabbed the umbrella and sauntered off with it slowly. The man at the cigar light followed hastily. My umbrella, he said sternly. He went in the shop and he started claiming that umbrella belongs to him. And what happened? That man, he himself kept that umbrella from somewhere else. And he saw that, he thought that this man is real his owner. So he ran away from the scene. And the Soapy, he was worried. What is going to happen with me? Even he don't know. His destiny is against, not in the favor of Soapy. Whatever he is doing, it was going just opposite. My umbrella, he said. Oh, it is still Soapy, adding insult to petty Larsen. Well, why don't you call a policeman? I took it, your umbrella. Why don't you call a cop? There stand one on the corner. Larceny is theft of personal property. Still means mocking remark. The umbrella owner slowed his step. Soapy did likewise with the premonitions that luck would again run against him. Premonition is a warning. Premonition, warning. The policeman eyed at the two curiously. Of course, said the umbrella man. Well, you know how these mistakes occur. If it is yours umbrella, I hope you will excuse me. I picked it up with morning in the restaurant. If you recognize that yours, why I hope you will. Of course, it's mine, says Soapy savagely. Savagely means rudely. The next umbrella man reiterated. The policeman hurried to assist a tall blonde in an umbrella block across the street in front of a street car that was approaching 2 blocks away. So there was a cop. They were on the patrolling. They saw that Soapy, he was at the spot, and that umbrella man, he ran away. And after looking at policeman, that man, he thought that cop will arrest him. So he himself has kept that umbrella from somewhere else. So he thought that police is coming to arrest me. Means might be Soapy has called that cop or what. But they were for patrolling. So he ran away from the scene. And in this way, Soapy, he was very much depressed, disappointed, and he was very much angry. So then what happened? He flew away. that umbrella in the excavation because whatever is thinking, it was going against his plan. Okay, so this is the main idea of our passage number 3. So in passage number 3, what we done? He entered in the mingled in the Hartford College annual social gathering, and he misbehaved there so that the police could catch him, and he wanted to be under the clutches of the policeman. Okay, then what happened? It was just going opposite. Then the next episode is that he entered in the shop, and then he started claiming the umbrella, and that man, he himself has stole the umbrella from somewhere else. So okay, so this is the main idea of passage number 3. Now let us have a glance over the passage number 4. In passage number 4, what happened? It is the climax of the story. Climax of the story is that Soapy, he was very much disappointed. So he thought that to go back to his old house, Miss Madison Square. Madison Square is the place where there was there is a garden. So the garden park bench, he is spending his whole day. So he thought that now I will go back to my house where Madison Square. That park bench is home for Soapy. So on the way, what happened? On his way, he heard a Sabbath anthem. Sabbath anthem means what? The weekend, I mean Saturday and Sunday, is observed as a off day in Christianity and Judaism. In this region, the people, they used to abstain from work. Okay, they are taking the break. So on Sabbath day, he was passing nearby the church, and he heard the organist, organist means musician. They started playing the music. It is a hymn in favor of Almighty God. So the hymn, the music of the hymn, it appealed the Soapy a lot, and from here onwards, a big revolution came into the mind and heart of the Soapy. So big changes has come now. Sabbath anthem brought a big revolution in his life. He wanted to now to live a dignified life. So earlier he led a criminal type of life. So now what happened? He brought a big changes by hearing this Sabbath anthem. So he want to lead a dignified life. He want to live a honorable life. He must be respected in the society. He wanted that others should, other people should recognize him. So he's fighting just like identity crisis. Earlier he was like a criminal, but now what happened? He wanted to be a dignified and honorable personality in the society. Then what happened? A foreign porter offered him a place as a driver. He got job also. A foreign porter, he has given him as a job of a driver. Okay, here I am. Then in the end, he caught by the police and sentenced for 3 months imprisonment. In the end, what happened? He was caught by the police. So when he wanted to bring changes in his life, so what happened? It on the contrary, it gone just opposite. The police personnel, they caught him, and they presented him in front of the magistrate court, and magistrate ordered him the sentence for 3 months imprisonment. So this is the his main idea of our passage number 4. Okay, so now let us have a glance over the text. Page number 31. Soapy walked eastward through a street damaged by improvements. He hurled the umbrella angrily into an excavation. He muttered against the man who wear helmets and carry clubs because he wanted to fall into the clutches, they seemed to regard him as a king who could do nothing wrong. At length, Soapy reached one of the avenues to the east, where the glitters and the turmoil was but faint. He dragged himself toward Madison Square for home instinct, even when the home is a park bench. But on an unusually quiet corner, Soapy came to a standstill. There was an old church, quaint and rambling and gabbled, through one wide stained window of soft light blue, where no doubt the organist loitered over the key, making sure to his mastery of the coming Sabbath anthem. For there drifted out of the Soapy's ear sweet music that caught and helped him transfix against the formulations of the iron fence. So what happened on the way? He took a halt. He stopped nearby the church, and from there he started hearing that organist, they were playing the music. So that that song, music song, appeal to the Sopi and his mind and hearts is purified. So earlier it was full of criminal misintention. Now what happened? It has purified. After hearing all these things, so he started lamenting, what type of life I had spent in the past. So he was having lamentation. So in this way, the Sopi, what happened? He wanted to change his life. Then after reporter, he offered him a job. Okay. Then next, Rambling and Gabbering. Quen means attractive. Stand still means stop. Different means intention. So his intention is to lead a means honorable life. Transfix means to hold motionless. Motionless, transfix. Convolution means twist. Convolution, twist. The moon was above all full and radiant. Vehicles and pedestrians were few. Sparrows twittered sleepily in the eaves of a little while. The scene might have been a country churchyard. And the anthem that the organist played cemented Sopi to the iron fence, for he had known it well in the days when his life contained such things as mothers and roses and ambitions and friends and immaculate thoughts and colors. The connection of Sopi's receptive state of mind and the influences about the old church brought a sudden and wonderful change in his soul. He viewed with rising horror the pit into which he had tumbled. He degraded days. Unworthy desires, dead hopes, wrecked faculties, and base motives that made up his existence. And also in a moment, his heart responded thrillingly to his restrained mood, a strong impulse moved to him. Battled with this desperate fact, he would pull himself out the mire that would make a man of himself again. He would conquer the evil that had enslaved him. Mire means unpleasant situation. Convolution is a twist. So big twist has come now. What happened? After hearing all this song, so revolution has come into the life of the Sopi. So he wanted to live a honorable life. So whatever happened in the past, so he is having the regret of his past life. In the past, he was living just like criminal activities. He was involved in criminal activities. He pelted the stone. He claimed the umbrella. He was entering in the hotel without money. He is eating. So all these things, he did. So now what happened? Now big changes has come. So he realized his mistake, what he did in the past. There was time he was young yet, and he would restrict his old eager ambition and pursue them without faltering. Resurrect means restore to life. Restore to life, resurrect. Faulting means losing strength. Those solemn but sweet organ notes had set up a revolution in him. Tomorrow he would go into the rolling countdown street and find work for reporter. So what happened? Now he has decided that tomorrow I will go in the district and there I will find some job. So he went to the fur importer, and he is ready to offer him a job of a driver. He got a job also. So he is about to start his new life. That is based on dignity. So what happened? He was about to start, but in the end, what happened? The cop arrested him, and they presented him in front of the magistrate court. And in this way, the court ordered 3 month imprisonment to the Sopi. So in this way, the Sopi he was trapped under the clutches of the police. So what is the twist? When he was a criminal, so at that time he wanted that police would arrest him. But then there was a selfish gain of Sopi of entering into the Winter Island for that purpose. For means grabbing those opportunity, entering into the prison, he will get the foods, clothes, shelters, warm water, and in this way nothing, no work he has to do. Okay, so like that way he was thinking. But what happened? Police was not arrested. But now, when he wanted to change his lifestyle, he wanted to become an honorable personality in the society, that people should respect him. So he was having this type of intention. But the cop, they arrested him, and in this way he was put into the jail. So this is the twist, and this is the climax of the story. So that is why the Sopi, he was very much annoyed when his plan was failed. And when he wanted to live an honorable life, at that time he was put behind the bar. So this is the main idea of passage number 4. So dear student, if you are having any doubt regarding the second part of this lesson, then you give your comment on our comment box section of the YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching this video, and you write your comment or on our Google account that we have given you. There you write your presenting, and in that presenting you write your name. Okay, if you are having any doubt, then please contact me personally on my personal number. Thank you.